Hey folks, Joe Wood here with Chesapeake Bay Foundation. I'm a scientist in our Richmond, Virginia office. At the Bay Foundation, we love oysters. We love to eat them. We love oyster restoration. We love everything about them, really. But today I was actually hoping to spend a little bit of time talking to you all about another group of organisms, another group of bivalves that is really interesting and has captured my heart over the past few years. And that's freshwater mussels. Most people don't know very much about freshwater mussels. Even my scientist friends often are not aware of some of the cool things about them. So I hope this is interesting to you all. Freshwater mussels are a group of organisms. The class of organisms is called Unionidae, and it's very biodiverse. In the Bay watershed alone, we have nearly 50 different species throughout the watershed, throughout the freshwater portion of the watershed. They're not edible, at least it's illegal to eat them in the state of Virginia because they're threatened in many different places. They also, from what I've told, have a rather muddy taste, and there's just not that desire to have a commercial component for them. But freshwater mussels, what's interesting about them? One of the things that's really interesting is their life history. And the way that freshwater mussels reproduce is, at least some of the species, wave around this little thing that looks like a fish. If you get a chance, just go Google freshwater mussel lure, and there's some great footage out there. And they wave around this thing that looks like a little fish, and then, you know, a fish comes along and takes a bite of that, that lure that this mussel is putting out, and it pops like a water balloon. And upon popping, it releases these tiny baby mussels called glaucidia that cling to the gills of the fish and basically hitch a ride for the next 3 weeks upstream. Mussels cannot move on their own, at least not more than a few feet in a day. And so this life history strategy they've developed allows them to migrate upstream. And so there's unique lures to each different organism, each different species of organisms. Some freshwater mussels, instead of using a lure, have these things called superglutinates, where they basically have this long stringy material, almost like a spider web, which they let their juveniles cling to. But most freshwater mussels have this link with some fish in order to complete their reproductive cycle. And as a result of that, there is a number of challenging things related to the restoration of freshwater mussels. For instance, in order to make baby mussels, biologists have to basically simulate this whole process in the laboratory in order to make that happen. A number of mussels are unique to a single species of fish, and oftentimes scientists don't even know what fish that is. And so with these, you know, almost 50 different species that we have in the watershed, restoration is a real challenge. Now, most of you may have heard that, you know, oysters have good water quality benefits for the bay. They filter water, they have a chance to remove nitrogen, and mussels are no slouches themselves. They really filter about the same amount of water. They accelerate pollutant removal. Sometimes that pollutant removal is temporary, sometimes they're just removing things from the water, and then it eventually is released back, but sometimes there is a permanent removal through a process called denitrification. So these organisms, you know, super cool from my perspective. They're very pretty. I have here a northern lance shell. You can see it's much different than some of the mussel shells that you might see in the saline waters, like ribbed mussels. There's this very papery feel to them. And actually, historically, one of the things that threatened freshwater mussels, there was a button industry. They used to make shirt buttons out of this pearly material. And so in some places in the Midwest, you'll just find these giant stacks of shells with holes punched out of them. And that really decimated mussels in a number of different places. But there's a lot of other things that threaten freshwater mussels as well. They're pretty sensitive organisms. One challenge is dams. And you know, because these organisms rely on fish to transport their juveniles upstream, dams in some places have cut off their host fish and thus cut off mussel habitat as well. There are places in Pennsylvania where there are groups of mussels the same ages as dams that have been built. And essentially, the only populations of mussels remaining are those that were there before the dam was built. So there's certainly threats related to dams. There's also water quality concerns. They're sensitive to a number of different pollutants, such as ammonia, chlorides, metals, and a number of other things. Many of the things that threaten bay health are big threats to freshwater mussels. And so they're really incredible organisms that have these nice benefits for water quality. And they also create habitat. So juvenile or mussel populations, mussel beds at the bottom of a stream improves the amount of macroinvertebrates or bugs that can live there, which leads to a healthier food web. And so at the Bay Foundation, you know, save the bay, it's our motto, and that includes the entire watershed. And so a few thoughts I'll leave you with is first that freshwater mussels, I think, are part of what we are trying to save with bay efforts. Certainly, we talk a lot about restoring the reefs of the Chesapeake Bay. We talk about restoring kind of the iconic species. But freshwater mussels, which I didn't mention this, but they're one of the most threatened and endangered groups of organisms in the country. There are more species of freshwater mussels that are endangered than nearly any other type of animal in the entire country. They are an important resource in the freshwater portion of the Bay watershed that improve water quality that we're trying to protect as well. So A, there's something that we are trying to protect in our effort to save the Bay. Number two is that they have benefits for the Bay. They have the chance to intercept pollution on its way down to kind of the coastal ecosystem. And so they're incredibly important and they're incredibly interesting. So thanks for hanging out with me. And if you ever want to chat about freshwater mussels, I'm all for it. It's something I just absolutely love to talk about. Thanks.